So today we are gonna play Sally Face. I do know some stuff about this game. I have seen some of it, but I have never personally played it. I'm late to the party, so we're gonna play it, and it should be a very exciting time for everyone. And we're just gonna start a new game. It was just like the last time. Only this time, it started in a hospital. Okay. Hello? It's okay, Sal. Everything is going to be okay now. Come and see. Who is this? Sal. Come and find me. Okay. Weird. Sounded like my dad. Alright. Looks like something's there, but it's too dark to see. Okay. Where's the light switch? Did that painting of the dog just change? Ooh, a key. Okay. A key! Wait, what? Oh, cool. Interesting. D. P. O. N. M. There's a 3 here. Let's go through O. H. G. F. E. The sound of her feet hitting the floor is really exciting. Hang on a hot minute, my cat's in here, and she's not supposed to be in here. Alright, took care of that, which was a good thing, because it helped me realize I didn't switch my camera over. Anyway. A, B, C, D. Let's try C. Alright, so D is the correct one. And then O. E. D. O. F. D. Oh. G. Okay. There's a dog here. Who's a good doggy? Who's a good boy? I buried her alive, kid. You tell me. Huh? This dog be burying people. Go see for yourself. Okay. Oh. Diane Fisher, 1948 to 1984. Beloved mother and wife. The music's fun. Batteries not included. Passcode. It's locked. Sure. All right. Hello. Dad?
You are not my son. My son is not a murderer.
Okay. This is your fault. Mom? Are you... I didn't like that! And that's when I woke up.
Yes. It's an interesting dream. I think we should come back to that dream later, but for now, you can tell me more about the body.
Which one?
The second one, the one from the apartment.
Dad and I had just moved in. I had a weird feeling about that place right away. Episode 1, Strange Neighbors. Strambers, if you will.
This will be our new beginning. We can finally leave what happened in New Jersey behind us now. Why don't you go explore the building and make some friends while I finish unpacking?
Okay. Righto! Look at us. Look at us go. Can we go in our own room? There's a cat here, Gizmo.
I see you've made yourself at home already, Gizmo. Must be nice.
Nothing to see here. We can leave. We can go in Dad's room.
Hey kiddo, decided to take a break from unpacking? That's not a bad idea, we've been at it for a while now. Maybe I'll take a break myself.
I miss Jersey.
I know you do, bud, but please try to give it a chance. School will start up in a couple weeks, and then you'll be able to make all new friends.
Yeah, I guess so.
I know so. Anyone would be lucky to have you as a friend, Sal.
Thanks, Dad.
Mm-hmm.
I miss Mom.
Yeah. Me too, buddy. Me too.
What do you think about this place?
It may not be as nice as our old house, but we'll make the best of things. As long as we have each other, I think we can make a real home here.
See ya!
Try not to get into too much trouble.
Bye, Dad! We can leave? Bags. Just some stuff Dad got from the store. Nothing important. Sleep aid. Dad still has trouble sleeping at night after something. Leave. Sal's place, number 402. Got an elevator. We got a cop. Hello. Why are you standing here?
I'm protecting nosy little freaks like you from seeing what they ought not to see. Now scram! I don't get paid to babysit.
Who are you?
I'm your fairy fucking godmother. What does it look like? I'm an officer of the law, so you better show me some respect.
What happened in that room?
Police business, kid. Why don't you run along back to your parents?
I wish I could.
What was that wise ass?
Nothing.
That's what I thought. Stupid weirdo kid. Okay, fine. You grump. No one's home. Alright. We're gonna go on the elevator. We'll just, let's go to the fifth floor. This floor is currently being renovated. For your safety, please make your way to the nearest exit. Open. It's locked. Open. Hello? Sorry, I didn't know anyone lived up here. Hello, sir? Are you okay? You shouldn't have come here. I'm sorry, I was just trying to get to know my new neighbors and... A dark place. This building. Horrible things happen. Are you sure you're okay? And he's gone. What the? Okay. We'll leave. Creepy. Super creep. Locked. Locked. Alright. Creepy, creepy. Alright, let's go to 3. We can't go this way, the floor is wet. No one's home. Hey. Oh my. Sorry, you just startled me a little. You must be one of the new guys from 402, yeah? With all that excitement going on today, I haven't had a chance to stop in and say hi. Yeah, it's just me and my dad. My name is Sal. Pleasure to meet you, Sal. I'm Lisa. I take care of this place, keep things up and running. So if you ever need help with anything, don't hesitate to ask, okay? Sure, thanks. You're quite welcome. Alright. Finally, someone that isn't creepy and isn't mean. Knock, knock. No one's home. Knock, knock. Who's there? No one. Yeah, who's there? Hello, I'm new in the building. Just wanted to introduce myself to the neighbors. Okay, come in. Hi, my name is Sal. I just moved in today with my dad. What the hell is with your face, child? Oh, I know. Young teens, a new generation of self-expression. I was young once myself, I get it. Just so long as you're not in a gang or anything. You're not in a gang, are you? No. It's nothing like that. Wonderful. Well, I'm Charlie. Don't mess with my stuff and we'll be okay. I'm a collector, you see. I collect many things. These things are like my family. So if you mess with my collections, you're messing with my family, got it? Yes, sir, not a problem. I won't be giving you any troubles. Good to hear. Bask in the glory of my complete set of glitter ponies. A great accomplishment it is to have this full set. You can look all you want, but don't even think about touching them. What's a glitter pony? Silver's trying to move his rocks in Animal Crossing, and he just yelled that he did it. Also, dang, that zoom. My god, child, have you never seen My Glitter Pony's Rainbow Spectacular? It's only the greatest television show ever produced. It's got drama, action, romance, comedy, everything you could want. And the ponies. Oh, the ponies. Don't even get me started. Yeah. I guess I missed that one. I'll have to look for it on TV. Yes, you will. Trust me, you won't regret it. I like your top shelf more than this shelf. Is that it? Got anything else to tell me? So... Yup, I know. You're speechless because you've never seen such an awesome collection. Yeah. Don't worry, anytime I'm home you can stop by and take it all in again. Nice place you got. It's my own chunk of heaven, just me and my stuff. Do you live here alone? Alone? Look around you. I have all the company I could ever need. Well, it is nice to have a visitor from time to time, I suppose. Alright. Well, I'm gonna go. But, have fun with your glitter ponies. No one's home. No one's home. I guess no one is home. I would like to think that someone is home. Alright, number one. Addison. Oh dear, what a fright. Pardon me, let's start over. Hello, young sir, new resident of Addison Apartments, room 402. How may I be of service? How do you know who I am? I know all that takes place within these walls, sir. You'll do good to remember that. Can I come in? Heavens no! I'm afraid that I'm quite particular about my privacy. I'm sure you understand. Sure. Goodbye. Farewell, friend. No one's home. And no one's home. Is someone home here? Yeah, what do you want? A little early for a trick or treating, isn't it? Stupid, good for nothing kids. Rude? This is my face, ma'am. I think we said hello to everyone. Let's talk to this lady again. She was nice. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sal. What's up? How long have you been working here? Actually, I don't just work here. I live here, too. I'm on call 24/7 for any urgent maintenance needs. Despite what you may hear from others, this is a lovely building. I'm happy to call it home going on 10 years now. Seems like a nice place. You betcha. What do others say about the building? Oh, all kinds of stuff. I'm sure this building is well over 100 years old, you know. People are always complaining about one thing or another. But you'll hear no complaints from me. I'm a woman of action. If I see a problem, I fix it. Yeah, most people do seem to complain a lot about the small things. You can't sweat the small stuff, Sal. It's just no way to live, you know. You're right. Take it from me. You focus on the good stuff. Focus on what makes you happy in life. Put your energy into that. Alright. So do you know anything about what happened in 403? It's a shame you and your dad had this crummy first impression. I promise things aren't typically so gruesome around here. Poor Mrs. Sanderson. Who's Mrs. Sanderson? Oh, never mind that. Best not to set your mind on such dreadful things. Is this building haunted? Sal, sweetie, I've been taking care of the Addison Apartments for a long time, and I've never seen any ghosts or goblins. That's just people's overactive imaginations. Too much sweets and scary movies, if you ask me. Is there anything to do for fun around here? You know what? I have a son around your age. I think you two would get along great. He's downstairs in our apartment. You should go introduce yourself. Sure, I'll go say hi. Great. His name is Larry. He'll be in the basement. Tell him I sent you down. You'll need a key card to access it from the elevator, though. Here, take this one. I've got a few extras. Cool, thanks. Well, I'm gonna go say hey to your son. See you around. Gee, I sure am looking forward to using this. Not. The background music in this is very, I don't know. It's nice. I like it. I like that it's, like, just a little bit weird. Lots of tasty junk food. I'm not really hungry, though. Just walk on in, don't even knock. What the hell was that? Yeah, exactly. What the hell was that? Just lurking around your place. Don't mind me. Let's go in Lisa's room. It's locked. Alright, let's go say hey to Larry. Yeah? Hey, Larry, your mom said I should come say hi. I just moved into 402. Oh, hey, come on in. Door's open. Look in. Your soul will be destroyed. Odin's blood, zombie everything all the time. Fear within. All right. Whoa, nice mask. They made her eyes so, his eyes so creepy. His. It's a prosthetic. Oh, shit. Sorry, man. It's cool. I'm used to much worse by now, so I'm glad you like it. So, do you, like, have no face under there? What happened? I'd rather not talk about it. Okay, change of subject. I'm Larry. I live down here with my mom. He looks like that 70s show character. I'm Sal. My friends call me Sally Face. I just moved here with my dad from New Jersey. Sally Face? I guess I didn't really have any decent friends, to be honest. So once they started calling me that, I figured if I owned the name, then the assholes couldn't use it against me. Good on ya. You're a complicated dude, aren't you, Sal? You're pretty strange. I like you. We're gonna get along great. Huh? That's what your mom said, too. Mother knows best. Why do you live in the basement? My mom always says it's because we gotta guard the place from rats. But I'm pretty sure she gets this room rent-free with the maintenance gig. It's cool, though. I don't mind it. Get to listen to music as loud as I want to when she's not around. Nice. Yeah, it's like my own little bat cave. Like your shirt. Thanks. Stands for Sally Face. Heh. I do have my own clothing line, so... Haha, it's actually for this metal band called Sanity's Fall. Do you like metal? I don't know. Oh, that's gotta change. Check out this song. It's their first single. The full album comes out in a few months. Hell yeah, Larry! Let's get those spicy jams. I love it. Look at him air guitar. Dang. But we're gonna keep going. What happened in 403? Shh, not so loud, man. What is it? The killer is still in the building. How do you know that? I saw it, man. Are you high right now? I wish I was, man. This was some scary shit. What happened? Okay, so I was helping Mrs. Sanderson with a clogged toilet. I was just finishing up when I heard him burst in yelling like a lunatic. I know what you've done. Herman told me everything, you stupid bitch. She tried to calm him down, but before she could get even a few words out, he was cutting her throat wide open. I was shocked. I couldn't move. I was frozen by fear, man, just peeking through the crack in the bathroom door. Anyways, it all happened so fast, and then he cleaned up quickly and left. I don't know how, but he didn't even see me. I haven't really told anyone yet, not even my mom, but I trust you. You know who did it? Yeah, it was definitely Charlie, big creeper from 204. He was wearing gloves, so I don't think they got any prints or anything. Shouldn't you tell the cops? I actually tried to talk to that detective, but he won't listen to me without some kind of evidence. Like my word isn't enough. Alright. A mystery. What's up with the guy in 103? That's Mr. Addison. He owns this place. I don't think I've ever seen him leave his room. Always talks through his little mail slot. He's a nice dude, just real strange. Oh yeah, if you say Addison tea, please and thank you to him, he'll give you a cup of his famous tea. I hate the stuff myself, but the adults seem to love it. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Alright, bye Larry. Actually, I like your paintings. Thanks, dude. It's my passion. Okay, I think that's everything. Let's head back to our room. Say hey to our pops. Sup, Dad? At least he's trying now, not drowning himself in booze, not totally giving up on life, on me. Hey, a quarter, score. Okay. We got a quarter. Not really super clear on what I'm supposed to be doing right now, but that's okay. Maybe I'll go talk to the cop again now that I have something new to talk to him about. Or maybe I'll get some tea. Hello. Nope, nothing new to tell him. Maybe we'll go see Mr. Addison. Get some tea. Hello, young sir. New resident of Addison Apartments, room 402. How may I be of service? Addison tea, please, and thank you. Yes, coming right up. There you are, sir. Please enjoy. Should go see Charlie. Is that Addison tea I smell? Yeah, I just got some from. Oh, I just love Addison tea. Give it here. I forgot to do his voice. He's really getting into that tea though. Ah, so tasty, so relaxing. Okay. Ah, must have dozed off for a second there. I hope you weren't thinking about touching my ponies while I was sleeping, Sal. I was starting to like you. Wouldn't dream of it, Charlie. Good, good. I'm glad. Say, if you get any more ass and tea, I would love some more. Mr. Addison already cut me off for the day. Okay. We scored a quarter. Maybe we should go... I'm still not really hungry. I better hang on to this quarter for something else. Hello. Hello, young sir. New resident of Addison Apartments, room 402. How may I be of service? More tea. Yes, coming right up. There you are, sir. Please enjoy. Okay. Let's go, talk to Lisa, maybe. Just to say hey. Sup, Lisa. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sal, what's up? I met Larry. Oh, wonderful. I'm glad you kids got to meet. Me too, it's good to have a friend again. Larry's a nice guy. I knew you two would get along. Do you need any help? Are you poking fun at me for mopping the same spot for so long? Well, I like to be thorough, but to be honest, sometimes my mind just wanders and I lose track of time. That's cool, I'm the same way. I could tell you're a creative type like my Larry. I'm glad you two are getting along. Sometimes I worry about him. What do you worry about? Oh, I shouldn't be bothering you with this stuff. Let's keep things positive. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sal. Alright. Can try the fifth floor again. It's creepy up here. That's weird, the bathroom door is locked. I wonder if there's anything to be found over here. No. But the bathroom door is locked. So that's gotta be something, right? Maybe if I go talk to Larry. Let's go talk to Larry. I'm telling you, man. Seriously, I saw it happen. Alright, we already heard all this. Maybe we should investigate this shadowy figure we saw over here. Nothing. There's nothing over there. There's nothing in here. And Lisa's room is locked. And we already got, so we got tea from Addison. Should we just go give the tea to Charlie again, and maybe that'll work out? I know, they're so cool, aren't they? Yeah. I got more tea for Madison. Wonderful. Ah, so relaxing. Ah, must have dozed off for a second there. Hope you weren't thinking about touching my ponies while I was sleeping, Sal. Starting to like you. Wouldn't dream of it, Charlie. Good, good. Glad. Say, if you got any more tea Any more Addison tea? I would love some more. Mr. Addison already cut me off for the day. Let's just keep feeding him tea, I don't know. Just gonna give him all sorts of tea. Tea, please. Yes, coming right up. Just gonna keep investigating, seeing if there's anything. Oh. I was wondering where that was. Apparently I should push things more. Giving tea to Charlie is not correct. What's this thing? It's a police scanner. You can listen in on local cop chatter. How the hell did you get this thing? That's a story for another day, but hey, you just gave me a great idea. If I make a fake call, maybe I can distract them long enough for you to sneak into 403. Maybe we can find some kind of evidence to show that detective something they weren't looking for. Pretty quick to sign me up for the break-in. Well, I gotta make the call down here and... I'm just messing with you. I'm totally up for this. Been wanting to peek in that room anyways. Sweet. So what's the plan? I'll call in a bank robbery, hostage situation, and that should clear out the cops for sure. I'm guessing that'll buy us a few minutes until they figure out it wasn't real. You gotta be upstairs when I do that so we can make those minutes count. We can use my walkie-talkies to communicate during the whole thing. Then I can give you a heads up too, once I know the cops are coming. Sounds pretty solid to me. Maybe just switch the bank robbery with armed robbery at like a gas station or a drugstore. Make it a little more believable. Yeah, I guess you're right. Good call, Sally. Here, take this. Head to your room and let me know when you're ready. Just press that Y button there to call me. Okay, I'm in my room now. Alright, let's do this. I'm gonna make the call. Give me a second. Okay, it's done. I heard a bunch of hustling upstairs, so I think it worked. Go see if you can get into 403 now. There's a broken coffee table with some books. Look like anything important? Just looks like junk to me. Alright, keep looking then. There's gotta be something else. Man, this is pretty twisted. Tell me about it. There's these little figures. Looks like one is missing. I can see a small clearing in the blood. That's it. I know how we can get him. Get out of there and come down to the basement. Sanderson and Charlie both collected those weird toys. They're nuts over those things. Miss Sanderson got this super rare one or something. She was telling me about it that day I was fixing her toilet. Anyways, I bet you Charlie couldn't resist taking it. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if that's why he offered her in the first place. That dude always did give me the creeps. Just something unsettling about him, you know? Wow, this is crazy. This guy definitely needs to get caught. We can't live in a building with a murderer. Exactly. That's why you gotta get into Charlie's room and see if you can find that toy. Wait, why do I have to do it? I snuck into 403. Charlie isn't too fond of me. There's no way he'd let me in. He accused me of stealing snacks from his room. Snacks, fucking fatty. Alright, I'll do it. Won't be able to sleep at night otherwise. Cool, you're the man, Sally. Here, take this baggie. You can slip the toy in without touching it. Why do I get the feeling you've done this before? Haha, nah, just watch too much TV. Alright. I'll just go do all the work, Larry. It's fine. All right, we're gonna give him the tea. Ah, so relaxing. Ah, must have dozed off for a second there. Hope you weren't thinking about touching my ponies while I was sleeping, Sal. I'm starting to like you. Wouldn't dream of it, Charlie. Good. Glad. Say, if you get any more Addison tea, I would love some more. Mr. Addison already cut me off for the day. I know, they're so cool, aren't they? Yeah. Alright, so the tea knocks him out, but doesn't keep him out. There's sleep aid. Alright. There's sleep aid in my bathroom. I need to put him to actual really good sleep, so hang on. This may come in handy once I have something to mix it with. Is it? It's not in my inventory. Alright, we gotta go downstairs, get tea, come back up, put the sleep aid in it. Alright. Addison. Hello, young sir, new resident of Addison Apartments, room 402. How may I be of service? Yes, coming right up. Tea, please. There you are, sir. Please enjoy. Thanks. Now we go back to my apartment. Get some sleep aid. This will knock that fat bastard out for sure. Did you take all of them, Sal? Your dad needs those. It's pretty rude.
now go here. And we're gonna knock this dude out. Hey, what's up? Got another cup from Addison. As much as I love that stuff, I don't know if I can drink another drop today, as surprising as that sounds. Really? But it's fresh, nice and hot. Well, maybe. No, I don't want to overdo it. I've probably had at least 20 cups today. Are you positive? This is a new recipe Mr. Addison was trying out. I already had 3 cups and I thought it was way better than the other kind. Oh, I have to try that. Give it here. Ah, this is better than his original. I don't know how he... Good night. Got the choice. Score. Alright. Think we gotta go say hey to Larry. Alrighty. Sup, Larry? Did some breaking and entering at your request. Just make him play the song again. I got the toy. Alright, Mr. Smooth Criminal. I knew you could do it. Thanks, man. I was nervous for a second there. Bet now all you need is to do is give it to that detective. It'll be all over. Let's ask the other things. So is this place haunted or what? What? Not this again. Did Chug put you up to this? No, I just got a weird feeling about it. Who's Chug? He's the big kid on 3. Usually can't miss him, but anyways. I don't believe in ghosts. Never saw one with my own eyes, you know? I guess so. Play that song again. Which song? The one that goes bee boo boo bop? No, the one that goes beep, boo, boo, bop, beep. It's so great. And the fact that whenever you stop moving, Sal just gets going. Alright, we gotta give it to the detective. Hey man. How's it going, officer?
Hold on.
Don't you get tired of standing there all day? Any news on finding the killer?
If I find out you're tampering with police evidence, well, you better pray I don't find out.
How's it going, officer? I think I found something.
What the hell are you talking about, kid?
Well, I got this. Look, I'm busy here. If you got something important, go share it with the detective down on the first floor. Alright. Sounds good to me. Bye. Ya butt. Hi. What's going on?
Hello, young man. You just moved in today, correct?
Yes, sir.
I already spoke with your father. Seems you two were out of state when everything happened last night. Story checks out. That's good. Try not to get in our way for now, okay? We're investigating a serious crime.
Was it murder?
Can't talk about that.
I think I know who did it.
Have you been talking to that Larry boy? Can't put much faith in a teenager with a criminal record.
Look,
I appreciate you kids trying to help, I do, but unless you've got some sort of evidence, then please refrain from spreading rumors.
I've got evidence.
Let me see that. This came from Charlie's room? How did you get this?
I was just saying hello to my new neighbors, you know? Trying to introduce myself to everyone. I was in there talking to Charlie, and he was showing me all his toys. That's why I noticed one had blood on it. Thought for sure this would be helpful, so I grabbed it with my lunch bag.
Well, well. A little detective in training, huh? Haha, not bad, kid. I'll hold on to this. Just remember next time you come to us with this info instead of putting yourself at risk, okay?
Yes, sir, you got it. Maybe we'll go talk to Larry again? Okay, nothing to be said. Go up a level. He's still doing a snooze? A snoozy boy. All right, let's go more. I guess we'll go back to our room because I think we're done. How's it going, officer? Yeah, nothing new to say to him either, so I think maybe let's go talk to our dad. At least he's trying now, not drowning himself in booze, not totally giving up on life on me. See, you've made yourself at home already, Gizmo. Must be nice. Alright, there's still more to be done. We didn't really get to talk to anyone on the third floor. Maybe, Larry's mom is done mopping. Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sal. Hey.
Well, hey.
I'm Sal, just moved in. You can call me Sally Face.
Chug. Nice to meet you, Sally Face.
Nice meeting you, Chug. How'd you get your nickname?
Huh, what nickname?
Never mind. Do you think this building is haunted?
Why, did you see something too?
Yeah, I think so.
Knew it. I knew it! Not crazy. Ha!
So, you've seen that old man?
Old man, no. I think that's just crazy homeless dude that sleeps up on five sometimes. But I did seen lots of stuff, man. Crazier stuff than just that old bum. Like, things moving all by their own and weird noises and stuff, you know? Keep trying to tell everyone, but no one ever believes me.
Well, I believe you.
Ah, thanks, Sally Face. Oh, I did see a girl once.
Huh?
A girl. Thought it was a homeless guy's daughter, but she just disappeared. That's why I use my key to lock the bathroom shut tight. It's too scary.
Wait, you have a key to 504?
Yep, found it on the ground.
Let's go check it out together.
No way, not going in there. Ghosts live in there.
How about you let me borrow the key and I'll check it to make sure it's safe?
Can't just give you the key, but maybe you can trade me something for it.
I bet he wants snack. Let's go get him snack.
Wanna trade? If you let me borrow the key, I could give you,
a quarter.
Oh man, heck yes, here, take it.
All right, let's go see the spooky ghost. Spooky ghost, spooky ghost. All right.
Is anyone in here? It's okay, I won't hurt you. I'm a friend. You are?
Yeah, sure. My name is Sallyface.
Your name is funny. You're not scared of me, Sallyface?
No, of course not.
Okay, that's good. Why do you have the pigtails in your hair? That's for girls, silly.
Ha, whoever said that only girls can wear their hair in pigtails. I like pigs, too.
I never thought of that. You're funny, boy.
Why were you crying for?
Everyone always runs away from me when I try to talk to them. I get so lonely up here all alone.
I can understand that. I get lonely sometimes too. It must be hard being by yourself.
Well, I'm not really all alone. There are...
Hello, little girl? Are you still here? Huh? Chug, what are you doing up here?
Asking myself that same question.
Thought you were too scared of this room.
I am, but you were gone for so long. I needed to check on you. You know, make sure the ghost didn't get you.
Thanks, man. I'm okay. Nothing got me.
Good, good. So I was thinking maybe you keep that key. I don't like coming up here anyway. You seem more into it.
Alright, I'll hold on to it. But you can borrow it anytime you want.
Okay, deal.
I feel like I just keep going back to Larry because I expect something relevant to happen when I talk to him. But, nope. Maybe there's more to do with Chug. Chug, chug, chug-a-roo. Okay, now he's gone. Let's go back in the bathroom. That noise is so creepy because it sounds like just someone knocking at the door. I'm gonna try going back to our place again. Okay, not Dad. Dad isn't the answer. Where shall we go? Bathroom? Nope. Kitchen? No, not the kitchen. Maybe we can try knocking on some other doors that no one was at. Chug. Hey, Chug.
Hi, Sallyface.
She's still here.
Hey, Lisa. Hey, Sal.
Nothing to be said there. Nothing new here. Nope, nope. No.
You again? Why do you kids insist on making my life miserable? Please just leave me alone. When will this torture end?
I can go outside.
Good work today, Sal. You can rest easy now. I'm innocent, I swear. I thought you were my friend.
No one was around, so I looked into the back window of the van. Wow. That's grotesque.
Such a horrific sight for anyone to see, let alone a young child as you were. 15 years old, Inora, you had witnessed 2 gruesome scenes. Must have been very traumatic for you.
Sure, I guess so.
And all these years later, the new evidence that finally proved Charlie was falsely accused. After so much of his life spent behind bars, how did that make you feel?
I'm not convinced it wasn't him.
Yes, so you've said.
What about Larry?
What about him? Like I've said, the guy was my best friend all through high school. And after high school?
We've been over this. I lost touch with Larry after graduation. I don't know where he is now.
He seemed to be upset by my mention of him.
I just don't know what good asking the same questions all the time is, do you? And I thought you were supposed to help me.
I understand your frustration, Sal, I do. I want to help you, but you seem to be holding something back.
I can't help you unless you're completely honest with me. Do you understand where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, our time is up for today. Wait, it's about Larry.
I'm sorry, Sal, you know how strict they are with the schedule. Please keep that thought for our next session.
Next week will be our last meeting before your trial, so I hope you'll let me help you.
I don't think you're a murderer, Sal.
You might be the only one. Alright. I think I'm gonna stop there. That seems like a really good point at which to stop. So I'm just gonna go through this little section of dialogue.
Sally, where are you?
So, I'm gonna end it there. It looks like we're in for something pretty neat. But that feels like a really good stopping point, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop here. I think that's pretty much like the first section of the game anyway, because when this game came out in parts. So I think that feels like probably the end of part one. So, bye. Ooh, I like the music right now. It's like a different version of the like intro music or whatever.